live from TD Garden in Boston, where tonight the Bruins take on a team that has been playing some pretty fine hockey of late, the San Jose Sharks. They cannot score fewer goals, can they? Tim Heath's shot, the save, and the rebound, and there it is. The first rebound, and San Jose was first on it.
Yeah, it's a credit to their organization and their ability to find, the hidden gems, I guess, if you will, or guys that they feel can develop into players.
It's the way San Jose plays. Agostino on a mistake by the Sharks gets a second chance, and Martin Jones, who is a huge 6'4", and seems to be a lot bigger than 195 pounds, blocks a lot of goals.
Well, the first clean breakout by Boston with some possession. A nice little touch pass up the wall. Nash gains the red line, and it's a good force by Vetrano.
Pass to David Backes playing center. Here is Jake DeBrusk, sizzles one high over the glove side. McAvoy on a forward venture. DeBrusk shuttles it. Here's Backes following, and the Bruins buzz around Martin Jones's net.
Well, starts back in the defensive zone on a clean breakout again. Now you have speed through the center zone. You can activate the D. McAvoy looking for that simple little give and go after the initial shot by DeBrusk misses the net. They're able to retrieve the puck and get the puck back to the top of the blue paint.
Back to pick it up. Finds Backes in the seam. The Bruins get a breakout shorthanded. Danton Heinen just called up. Back to Backes. Heinen scores! Danton Heinen with his first NHL goal. Shorthanded. And the Bruins are on top.
So much to love about this goal, Jack. Of course, the finish is a beauty. But it starts with Kevin Miller in his own zone, shorthanded. He's going to win a puck battle. No panic. We talked about when you're playing with a guy like Kevin Miller, come low if you're a winger. Shorten it up the passing route. And that's exactly where Backes was. And this is 4 versus 5. Backes comes down low. Miller hits tape to tape. Heinen comes across. Now you got a little speed through the neutral zone. And it's a simple little give and go, even though it's 2-on-2.
And it'll be interesting to see how Heinen's confidence surges. Brent Burns with a rocket save by Hudobin. The rebound hurdle. LeBanc into the middle. Bodker on the backhand. The Bruins scrambling and gets the puck to Ryan, who McAvoy plants on his keister right at the penalty bench doors. Anders Bjork with speed stops up Bergeron's drive and up into the protective netting. Charlie McAvoy bringing the physical game on the top pair tonight with Zdeno Chara. Now LeBanc rushes up ice, crisscrosses behind Bodker, gets the return from Tierney. What a save by Hudobin, and he snatches it out of the air as LeBanc tried something from forward of the goal line.
Bergeron gets caught playing defense in this situation in the neutral zone because of the read by Krug. And it's good recognition by the Sharks. You want to isolate as best you can, and the Bruins get a little spread out defensively. Pinches were there.
Joe Thornton is in an open side. Can't pick the corner. The rebound. Pavelski unable to jam it past Hudobin. The puck on edge. Ryan, the defenseman, all the way forward to the goal line. Here's Brent Burns, the one-timer saved by Hudobin as the puck changed direction and came up on his chest. Did Melker Carlson get a tip on that? So San Jose, once again, to the power play. 0-for-3 with 2 power play shots on goal. Heath shot the tap, Thornton. Took all of 6 seconds for the Sharks to tie the game on the power play.
Well, Corrali's in the box, and we're going to give an opportunity to see why. The play was along the boards in the defensive zone. And he got in there, and he's in an awkward spot. He's trying to move this puck forward. He's trying to shovel it to Schaller. But the referee said he closed his hand on it. So there's your minor penalty. Face-off win. Burns takes that puck to the middle of the offensive blue line. And now it's a battle in front of the net. And Chara initially is with Pavelski. Carlo is initially with Thornton. Thornton able to bang it in on the back end on the power play to tie it.
The Bruins had a 1-0 lead thanks to Danton Heinen's first NHL goal, coming shorthanded from David Backes and Kevin Miller in the first period. Brandon Carlo's drive. Heinen has 2! And Boston is ahead again.
great follow-up shift to an important shift just prior to this goal by Hyde. The back is Pasternak, line was out there. They get the puck going in an offensive direction after the tying goal by Thorne on the power play. They needed a little something to build off of. And it's a forecheck themselves. You know, we've talked about San Jose and their ability to forecheck. Well, the Bruins get one here as a result of the forecheck. Jones has possession of the puck. He's just making a possession play to his defenseman, Vlasic. But it's forced off the play. You want to get in on the forecheck. It's exactly what the Bruins were able to do.
Backus not out. Heed's blast saved by Hudobin, and he clamps the trapper down on the right leg pad. Tries to toss the puck forward. Vetrano up high on Martin Jones. Schaller and Jones, a leg save. Vetrano from a knee couldn't get leverage to get the puck over the right leg.
His line mates, if he didn't go down on his knee, he would have had the leverage. Here's that snapshot we talked about. That's when he's playing his best. When he's thinking shot, anytime he's across that offensive blue line right here, he corrals the rebound. But in order to do so, he's going to be way off balance. And he knows he has Jones down, but he tried to sneak it short side because he didn't have the leverage.
Left shot on the right side, brings it back, Heed's drive, a save by Hudobin, he had a pretty good view of it.
Well, San Jose puck possession in the offensive zone, all five Bruins down deep, that means the points are open. Hudobin gets a good look.
Joel Ward lugging it out of his own zone, here's Timo Meier closing the shot, saved by Hudobin. Meier tried to go between the glove hand and the left side of Anton Hudobin.
Puck gets by McAvoy, and it's what appears to be 2-on-1, and that's what Carlo's going to read here, Jack. So he's playing center field there. Carpenter's appears to be, at first blush, a 2-on-1, but the back check is there. You'd like to see Carlo read that a little sooner and not let Meier get inside the dot and get a quality scoring chance.
Bergeron races down the boards, away from Braun. Pasternak, Bergeron there in support. Agostino's drive, save, Jones rebound, Marchand off the side of the goal.
And it was all about possession. We're showing you Krug with the puck, but it was Bergeron down deep that kept the play alive, got it back to Krug. They set up Agostino for the one-timer, purposeful shot. Yeah, he's trying to score, but it's an area that you're going to get a rebound that'll be down on the ice.
Tim Schaller pursues the puck to the far side. Joe Pavelski through the skates, but Riley Nash waiting for it. Schaller tries to angle in on Burns, goes for the wraparound, and a leg save by Jones. Schaller off the quarter boards. For Toronto, back to McAvoy, the blast, and Jones comes up big again.
And then keep making plays in the offensive zone. Keep the pressure on. Keep on that attack mode. Don't go to a prevent defense. And the Bruins are doing all of that here through the first half of this third period. Good cycle in the offensive zone. Good puck possession.
LeBanc has no room against Chara. Circles and finds a little space. Chips it in front. Hurdle gets planted as Hudobin finally finds the puck.
And then a little space in behind him. Carlo's got a read, come across quick because he knows Bergeron will try to come back down to the top of the crease. So good tandem work by the penalty killer.
Kevin Miller tries to waste the clock in front of the Zamboni doors, and the siren sounds. Anton Hudobin with some excellent third period work, turning aside 36 of 37 San Jose shots on the night, and the Bruins get a much needed 2-1 win over the San Jose Sharks.